Alecto Minerals is an African-focused gold and base metal exploration and development company listed on AIM. Now, their main focus is on the continuing development of the Kassanto gold project in Mali, where there's significant upside potential evident across the tenure. They also have a joint venture with Centamin over two prospective gold exploration licenses in Ethiopia. Well, joining us now is the CEO of Alecto, Mark Jones. How is the progress going at your Ethiopian gold projects?
Thanks. It's been going very well. As you mentioned, we do have this focus of both in East and West Africa. But what's been key to us is that we had two very large, significant blocks of land totaling roughly 3,000 square kilometers, which was just too big and too prospective to not have large budgets, which under the current market conditions was very difficult to get. So joint venturing with Centamin, who have a lot of energy for Ethiopia, has been critical, and this is the first time we've been able to formally update the market on the activities there.
Yeah, so what's the potential of this joint venture?
Well, the potential, of course, is to unlock what we hopefully get, which is a significant resource which will move over a period of time into a production process. We delivered to the joint venture drill-ready targets at our Wayu Boda project in the south. The acid metakel was more greenfields exploration. And this announcement is confirmation that Centamin have done sufficient work in acid metakel to confirm that they like the ground and want to go to the next level. We also, of course, announced that we have had confirmation from Centamin that they've drilled in excess of 2,500 meters at Wayu Boda, and from a geological point of view, all the holes have hit good structures, indicating opportunity for mineralization, and hopefully when the assays come back, something to crow about.
Now, are you prepared to sort of give any indication of the timescale of when, you know, what's going to happen next?
We don't manage the joint venture. The benefit to our company is that we don't have to pay, so we get all the upside without any of the financial exposure. But equally, we don't have the management of it, so we're totally in the hands of Centamin. I'd like to think that by the end of July we'd have information, but let me make it clear to any listener, it's not in my behest to specifically state what or where. I'm at the hand of Centamin, who are highly professional and do a proper job, and I'm very happy with what they're doing, but I just don't have any control on it.
Yeah. So Ethiopia, its potential is actually, well, it's a good site to be in. What's the appeal for you of Ethiopia?
Well, Ethiopia has been producing gold for literally thousands of years. It was historically a place where the Egyptian got much gold from. But there's only one producing gold mine, which is a private company called Midrock, who have the Legadembi mine. So the opportunity for, you know, systematic, proper, high-quality exploration to unlock all the areas which other potential gold mines can come from has been key. And as I said earlier on, we have this lovely ground, but it was 3,000 square kilometers. It's not something you can do with a small balance sheet. So the potential for there to be other Legadembis, other quality mines, is very real. And that's also the reason why, of course, Centamin, like the Nubian Shield, like Ethiopia, and very keen on this joint venture.
Yeah. What about Mali and the operations there?
Well, Mali's our biggest operational focus because we manage that from our own balance sheet. We have the Kassanto block, which historically has had a lot of work done on the eastern flank, which is the Gorbasi opportunity. We have two areas, east and west, close enough to be realistically seen as one project. And we announced in April that we'd got just under 200,000 ounces of gold there. And we also announced subsequently that on the western flank, where there are two separate parts of the resource, the infill drilling was looking good, and I have high hopes that we'll be able to close that gap and announce an updated resource shortly. On our western flank, we have Masakama, which has always been geologist's delight. It's a conundrum, and it means that we need to think very carefully as how we play it. But we've had a well-respected structural geologist there for 3 months continuously, and his view is that Masakama will be drill-ready in the next season. So unlocking that opportunity is something which we're keen to do as we advance Kisantu from our own balance sheet.
All right. Mark Jones, the CEO of Alecto Minerals, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much indeed.